today's thought. Don't depend too much on anyone in this world, because even your own shadow leaves you when you are in darkness. Today we are going to see second half of this prose, The Attic, written by Satyajit Ray. Having paid our bill and ascertained the location of Jokesh Abhiraj's house, we got into the car. Aditya was at the wheel. He expressed the wish to visit his house. "So, you do want to see your house after all," I said. Ascertained means confirmed. Now they paid their bill to Nagan uncle and Aditya, asking about Kabiraj's house address. Aditya expressed the wish to visit his house after confirmed Kabiraj's address. Now Aditya is driving the car. Now the narrator asked Aditya, "Do you want to see your house? It has become essential to do so," Aditya replied. His nerves seemed overwrought for some reason. We soon reached the house, which was surrounded by high walls. Even from the rains, one could easily imagine how grand it must have been once upon a time. Overwrought means state of being upset. So now Aditya replied, "Yes, it's very important. I want to see my house." Finally, both reached Aditya's house, which was surrounded by high walls. Now it looked like a dilapidated house. So the narrator saying, "I could easily imagine how grand the house once upon a time, but now it's looked like a dilapidated house." We entered the building, climbed up the stairs, and reached the attic on the second floor of the house. Now the narrator saying, we both entered the building. We entered the attic on the second floor of the house through the stairs. Attic means the space or room at the top of a building, under the roof. I had shown the image of attic in our previous class video, isn't it? So attic, this is the title of this prose. The attic. "This was my favorite room," said Aditya. "The attic has always been a favorite with the children. It is in the attic that the children seems to be in a world of its own." So now Aditya saying, "This was my favorite room," said Aditya, "and children always love attic. Attic is a favorite place of all children." Aditya said, "A portion of a wall of the attic had crumbled down, and through the window that had been created, we could see the sky, the fields, a part of the rice mill, the spire of the old temple. In the whole house, the attic had probably been the worst hit by wind and weather. The floor was strewn with twigs and straw and pigeon droppings. Among the other things, there was a broken cricket bat, the remains of the armchair, and a wooden packing case." Crumbled means broken. Spire means a tall or pointed structure on top of a building, especially on top of a church tower. Meaning in Tamil, koburam solluvanla, koil koburam, that is called a spire. One part of the attic was broken. So Aditya said, "We could see sky, rice field, rice mill, and temple tower through this hole. And the attic was badly damaged. In the room there was a broken cricket bat, armchair and wooden packing case, wooden box, okay. And the floor was strewn with twigs and straw and pigeons droppings. Aditya got on top of the packing case and pushed his hand inside the ventilator, thus upsetting a sparrow's nest, a part of which fell to the ground. However, he heaved a sigh of relief when he had got what he had been looking for. When I asked him what it was, he said, "You'll get to know very soon." Now Aditya, standing on the wooden box, and he pushed his hand inside the ventilator. Now he looked relief when he had got what he had been looking for. So narrator asked Aditya, "What are you searching for?" So Aditya said, "You will get to know very soon." We next went to a jeweler's to find out the weight of the article. The jeweler remarked that it was an antique. Our next stop was the house of Jokes Kaviraj. Though I was a little curious, I didn't ask Aditya anything. So now next, both went to jewelry shop to find out the weight of the medal. And the medal was antique. Antique means old. After that, they went to Jokes Kaviraj's house. So now the narrator said, "I was little curious," but the narrator didn't ask anything to Aditya. We entered the house and went to the room where Sazanka Sanyal stayed. Sazanka uncle was busy reciting verses from Tagore. When he had finished, Aditya asked, "May we come in?" He turned and faced us. Now both entered to the house of Sazanka Sanyal. Sazanka Sanyal was busy reciting verses from Tagore. Aditya asked, "May we come in?" after stopped reciting verses. So Sazanka Sanyal turned and faced them. "No one visits me," he said in an unperturbed manner. Unperturbed means undisturbed. Sazanka Sanyal faced them and saying, "No one visits me," with unperturbed, undisturbed manner. "Could you mind if we come in?" "Come in." So they are asking, "We come in?" Sazanka said, "Come in." Except for a short fire, there was nothing else to sit on. So we remained standing. There is nothing to sit except a chapai. Okay. "Do you remember Aditya Narayanan Chowdhury?" Aditya asked him. So Aditya asking, "Do you know Aditya Narayanan Chowdhury?" "Of course," said the gentleman. "Who is the gentleman?" So Sazanka Sanyal. Okay. "The spoilt child of affluent parents, was a fairly good student but could never beat me. He was extremely jealous of me and he used to tell lies." "Yes, of course, I know Aditya. He is a bad child of his parents. He is a good student but he was extremely jealous of me and he tell lies to," said Sazanka Sanyal. "I know," said Aditya. He then took out a packet from his pocket and hanging it over to him, said, "This is for you," from Aditya. Now Aditya saying, "Yes, I too know Aditya." And suddenly Aditya took something from his packet. and he said, "This is for you," from Aditya. Aditya said, "What is it?" he asked. "Money." "Money? How much money?" So Sasanka Sanyal asking, "What is it?" Aditya replied, "Money." "Money? How much money?" Sanyal asking, 150 rupees. "He has said that he will be happy if you accept it." Now Aditya replying, 150 rupees, "And this is for you. If you accept it, Aditya will be very happy." Aditya said, "Shall I laugh or cry? Aditya has given me money. Why this sudden generosity?" Means quality of being kind, meaning in Tamil, perundanmai. So now Sasanka Sanyal saying, "Shall I laugh or cry? What a sudden change of Aditya. Why this sudden generosity?" Sasanka said, "Man does change with time. Perhaps Aditya is not the same Aditya as before." So Aditya replying, "Man does change with time. Aditya is not a old Aditya. A change, I got the prize. He could not bear it. He took it from me to show his father and never returned it to me. Said that there was a hole in his packet and it had fallen through it." Now Sasanka is saying, "A change. I got a prize when I was younger. And Aditya asked me that medal to show his father. And after that, he never returned it to me. He said that was fallen through my pocket hole. This is the prize of the medal. It is yours." So now Aditya saying, "This is the prize of that medal and it's yours." Sasanka Sanyal was amazed. He stared at Aditya and said, "The price of the medal? That could not be more than 5 rupees. It was a silver medal." So now Sanyal was surprised and he is looking at Aditya and saying, "The price of the medal? No, that's a silver medal. That could not be more than 5 rupees. Silver is now 30 times costlier than before." So Aditya replying, "Silver is now 30 times costlier than before." "Really? I had no news of that." But Sasanka uncle looked at the 10 rupees notes in his hand and then looked at Aditya. There was a completely new expression on his face. He said, "Aditya, this smacks too much of charity, doesn't it?" Smacks means drive or put forcefully into or onto something. Now Sasanka Sanyal saying, "Really, I had no news of that." And he looked at the 10 rupees note which is in his hand. After that he looked at Aditya. His expression, face expression, was completely changed. And he said, "Aditya, this drive too much of charity, doesn't it?" We remained silent, peering intently at Aditya. Sasanka Sanyal smiled and said, "I had recognized you at Nagan uncle's tea shop. By that mole on your right cheek, I could see you had not recognized me. So I recited the same poem that I had recited on the prize giving day on purpose so that you may remember. Then when you came to visit me, I couldn't help venting my anger on you." Now Sasanka Sanyal saying, "I know you are Aditya. I identified you at Nagan uncle's tea shop. I just recognized that mole on your right cheek. but you had not recognized me. That's why I recited the poem, which I had recited on the praise given day. But still I have anger on you. Sanyal said with smile, you have done the right thing. You are grievous or absolutely justified, but I will be happy if you accept the money, said Aditya. Now Aditya saying, as you did right, your anger is absolutely justified, but if you accept this money, I will be very happy, said Aditya. Sasanka Sanyal shook his head and said, no, money will soon be spent. I would have preferred to have the medal. If it were possible, I could have forgotten the unpleasant incident of my childhood. If I could get the medal back. So Sasanka Sanyal shook his head and he said, I don't want money because money will soon be spent. So I want that medal. If it's possible, if you return the medal, I could have forgotten that unpleasant incident of my childhood. So the medal that had been hidden in the attic for 29 long years was eventually restored to its owner. So finally the medal returned to his owner after 29 years, which is hidden in the attic for 29 years. Sriman Sasanka Sanyal special praise for recitation 1942 was still clearly engraved on it. His name was still clearly engraved on it. This prose attic translated from the Bengali story Slekota.